this meeting. Today concept name is Selenium WebDriver. What do we mean by Selenium WebDriver? Selenium WebDriver is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. These set of programs we need to configure into one user interface. Why? Because these are programs. If you want to directly interact with these programs, compulsory we need one user interface. In the place of user interface, we are using Eclipse. What is Eclipse? Eclipse is nothing but it is a powerful editor to write the Java programs. If you want to write the Java programs, we will use Eclipse. Even developers also, they will use Eclipse, right? What is Selenium WebDriver? Selenium WebDriver is nothing but it is a software which contains some set of programs. This set of programs we need to configure into one user interface. In the place of user interface, we are using Eclipse. Okay, right. That means this Selenium WebDriver programs we need to install into Eclipse. How to configure Selenium WebDriver programs into Eclipse. Okay, right. Just right click on project. Properties. Java build path. Libraries. Add external jars. Choose jars. Click on OK. So now this is not Eclipse. Now Selenium WebDriver. In Java, we learned only one line. What is that line? Interface name, reference name,
new class name
equal to new class name. Here, interface is WebDriver. Reference name your choice WD equal to new class name. So in the place of class, we will take Firefox. Firefox or Google Chrome or Internet Explorer or Opera, whatever you want, you can take it. Now I'm taking new Firefox driver. Browser, we should take browser. Any browser, Firefox driver, right? Like WebDriver WD equal to new Firefox driver. Interface name, reference name equal to new class name. So WebDriver WD equal to new Firefox driver. First, how to configure Selenium WebDriver programs into Eclipse? Already we have Eclipse. I will show you Selenium WebDriver programs. Oh, these are Selenium WebDriver programs. We have 36 programs. These 37 programs we need to configure into Selenium. Eclipse. First, how to configure Selenium WebDriver programs into Eclipse? Just go to Eclipse first of all. 11 a.m. How to configure Selenium WebDriver programs into Eclipse? Delete. Okay. Right click, take new project, Java project. Click on next. Give the project name Selenium cell. I'm giving project name is Selenium. Click on finish. Now to configure, right click on project, go to properties, Java build path, libraries, add external jars, choose the jars where it is in the desktop, Selenium Java 2.21. So we have 37 programs. Control all, click on open, click on OK. Now this is Selenium WebDriver. Now Eclipse, this is the Selenium WebDriver. Go to SRC, take the new class. Class name is cell 1. Any name you can take it. Click on, click the mark public static void menu, click on finish. Same to same, only here we will write only one line, that is WebDriver WD equal to new Firefox driver. WD dot get HTTP facebook.com or google.com, gmail.com, gmail.com. Enough. After writing WebDriver, it will show you underline. So then keep the mark. It is a predefined class. So if it is predefined class, we need to import the statements. WebDriver, change to WebDriver, ORG, OpenQS, Selenium. Firefox driver. Change to Firefox, ORG, OpenQS, Selenium, Firefox. Enough. Save. Click on run. Only this line main. So it will open the Gmail page. See, it will open Gmail page. Without knowing Java, without knowing anything, directly we can work with any application. So this is the Facebook page. Sorry, Gmail page. If you want Facebook, just we should write Facebook here. Facebook.com. Save. Click on run. Nothing Java, nothing required. Without knowing Java also, directly go. We can write only one line, go Facebook. Okay. Here is any Java required. If you want to write this line, Java required? No. This line only, just WebDriver WD equal new Firefox driver. If you know that line, more than enough, right? First, go to Facebook. Go to Facebook. I want to enter username and password. I need to sign in. Facebook.com. Right, Facebook page. So this is the web application. This is the web application. So here in the web application, we have web elements. We have web elements. Web elements means this is the edit box, text box. This is one web element. This is one web element, text box. Login button. This is one web element. And this is one web element, this is one web element, this is web element, this is web element, this select box web element, web element, web element, link web element, radio box web element, web element, button web element, web element, all are web elements. These are all links are web elements. All links are web elements. All links are web elements. These are web elements. So each and every web element having one unique location. Each and every web element having one unique location. Each and every web element having one unique location. Unique location. That is called XPath. Each and every web element having one unique location. That is called XPath. Each and every web element having one unique location. That is called XPath. So we need to find out the XPath of the web element. Unique location. We need to find out the XPath. That means unique location. We need to find the unique location of web element. We need to find out the unique location of web element. So if you want to find out the web element XPath, compulsory we should know FirePath. We should know FirePath. What is FirePath? FirePath is nothing but it is a add-on of add-on of Firefox, which is used for finding the XPath of the web element. 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 So where we can get FirePath? We can get in Firebug. We can get in Firebug. What is Firebug? It is also add-on of Firefox. It is also add-on of Firefox, which is used for inspecting the web element. Inspecting the web element. Firebug is nothing but it is also add-on of Firefox, which is used for inspecting the web element. Inspecting the web element. We need to download Firebug and Firepath first of all. We need to download Firebug and Firepath first of all. How to download Firebug and Firepath? I will tell you first. How to download Firebug and Firepath? I will tell you. How to download Firebug and Firepath? I will tell you. Okay. Each and every web element having one unique location, that is called XPath. If you want to find out the XPath of the web element, compulsory we should have FirePath and Firebug. How to find out Firebug and FirePath, we will discuss now. How to download. First we need to download. How to download Firebug and FirePath. How to download Firebug and FirePath first. Right. How to download Firebug and Firepath. Go to Google. So I'm using old Firefox. I'm using old Firefox. New Firefox also we can use. Latest version of Firefox also we can use. I will tell you. But still old Firefox, old version I'm using. That's the reason old web driver, old Firebug and Firepath we need to download. So download Firebug. Download Firebug. Once only we need to download Firebug. Once if you install in your computer, it will be lifelong. Just click on second link, come down, click on an older version, click on an older version, click on 1.9. Click on 1.9, click on 1.9.0, click on allow, it will install. Only 30 seconds it will take. Click on install now. Yes, restart now, installed. So next, Firepath. just write fire path. Just click on first link. Add to Firefox. Just click on add to Firefox. Click on allow. Click on install now. Restart now. Installed or not, how we know? Just go to Firefox, web developer, Firebug installed. Open Firebug. Okay, this is the Firebug. This is the Firebug option. I will show you slowly, slowly. So this is the Firebug. This is the activator. Each and every time we need to activate this one. Go Firefox option. We can get the XPath here. We can get the XPath here. Right. First, I want to work with Facebook application. Just type Facebook. Right. I want to work with this Facebook. So activate here. Activator, once again, I am showing, just concentrate. Activator, just each and every web element XPath. If you want, take, just click on it. Activator, activate, it will be white, activate, just keep the cursor on username field, right? So this is the XPath, this is the XPath. So if you want, give the XPath here, only one line you should write. That line I will tell you now. WD dot web driver reference, WD dot find element by dot XPath. I'm giving the XPath. Copy the XPath and paste here. Already I find out the XPath. Just copy here. Copy. Control V. Enough. Dot. Send keys. Akhil ready. HYD 1 at gmail.com, my Facebook ID. All right. I want to give the password. WD dot find element by dot XPath. Just find out the XPath. How to find out, already I shown you. I will tell you once again. Send keys. I want to pass the data, so that's why I'm using send keys. Venkanna 143. Sign in. WD dot find element by dot XPath. I'm giving the XPath dot click. Dot click. Now. Activate password. I want password. Password XPath. I'm taking the password XPath. Copy. Control V. And I need to click on sign in button. Activate once again. Click on login button. Enough. Like, you can work with any application. After this class, you can work with any application. Enough. Control V. Save. Click on run. It will go, it will open the Firefox first of all. Next, it will go to Facebook. It will enter username. It will enter password. It will click on login button. Username, password. It will click on login button. Right. That is the concept. That is the concept. Like, you can work with any application, any application. Here is nothing required. Only if you write the only one line, more than enough. So after this class, you can work with any application. Just you should know only one thing. There are six types of web elements. One is select box, sorry, a text box. Text box means username password. One is text box. Second one is select box. Select box. Select box. Only text box and select box we will use send keys. We will use option send keys.
Never password.
Next. Link button image radio button will use
click
check box also seven we have seven web elements. So we will use click. After this class, you can work with any application without my support, without Google support, without any support, you can work with any application. That is the concept of Selenium WebDriver. Is there any Java required? If you want to work with any application, any type of button, well, these are the syntax. Text box, select box, we will use send keys. And link button, image radio button, checkbox. We will use click. Right.